band It's Been Real is in the studio here on the Dave Scott Show, 94.7 WNHN. Guys, how you doing? Welcome to the show.
How's it going, Dave?
How doing you doing,
good?
Dude?
Good, man. Good. Great. On Facebook, who's the most popular? Who gets the most likes?
Oh, me.
Is that what it's all about?
Oh, yeah. I'm really the strapping young lad with the good look.
So our style is very diverse.
You like hard rock?
Yeah, we there's passion.
But we do everything. Like, we got, like a funky jazz song. We have straight funk. We have hard rock. We have, like, a swing ballad song that
really?
We have. We kind of go everywhere.
What are some of your musical influences?
Oh, man. Anything from, like, Sly and the Family Stone to, like, Slipknot and anything in between.
And you have a CD that features original music. Tell us about some of your original songwriting.
When we started this band, it was just really, really natural and easy for us to just jump into songwriting really, really easily. Yeah.
Did you find that it takes a connection with another person to be able, you have to be on that some sort of level?
Yeah, there's definitely
I've
sat in my house with Johnny at 3 a.m. writing songs.
I'd like to hear what the young guys have to say about your thoughts on promoting music on the internet and social media in this day and age, as opposed to how bands did it back in the 70s and 80s.
That is the reason why
we
have
gigs.
The
platform is completely different.
Yeah.
I remember bands used to have to post their flyers up on telephone poles outside of clubs all the time, and that was the way to get it going.
Every once in a while, we'll print out flyers, because there are still bulletin boards that are local.
CDs, what are your thoughts on making CDs? A lot of people are trying to CDs the dinosaur of the music format in this day and age, right?
More or less. Yeah. I mean, vinyls are making a comeback.
Vinyls are making
a comeback. CDs might too, you know. You never know.
A lot of people are saying that vinyl is making a comeback.
In my personal opinion, I think
it's a short-lived thing. I think it's a curiosity fact. I think it's a short-lived thing. What do you think? People are phasing out CDs, so...
Yeah, I mean...
You know, I mean, digital really is the easier format to work with. I know that you have a good following. What's the easiest way to get your music out, guys?
Internet.
It certainly wouldn't be selling albums, right?
Yeah.
My point.
For those people who really like a physical form.
Yeah, I was going to say.
That's why we have the CDs.
And people do like the physical form.
We draw a little art on it.
Yep. It almost looks like graffitied spray paint.
Yeah, it's kind of funny how we came by that. Yeah.
You still have, is this available? Is your original music available online?
Yes.
And in
Spotify,
CD
iTunes,
format?
Everything. Yep.
Okay. Give us that. Hit us up with that one more time.
Spotify, iTunes, Bandcamp, YouTube, SoundCloud.
Are we on SoundCloud still?
We're still on SoundCloud. I hang out with the SoundCloud rappers out there, and I try to show them some rock
music. The
world
needs more SoundCloud rappers, for sure.
Being famous, is that something that you would like to achieve at some point in your career?
No, I want to live in a cardboard box for the rest of my life.
I want to live in a cardboard box a block away from Johnny.
I have
and
no
he's
ambition.
He's going to try to steal my cardboard box.
And I'm going to live in a giant mansion. Cardboard.
What?
Yeah, he's going to have a giant mansion, but it's going to
be made on cardboard.
Like, I thought I read that you want to take over the world.
Yeah, that's our bio. If they want to take over the world.
That's our mission statement.
Absolutely, they would want to be on the Dave Scott Radio Show.
We want to take over the world from our cardboard boxes.
Is this the first handful of songs that you guys worked on together?
Yes.
Okay, how would you feel the songwriting process is going between you? Do you feel like you have a chemistry?
Yeah,
absolutely.
You see yourself writing?
Like, quite a bit.
It's electric.
Yeah,
it's therapeutic.
See yourself writing... many more songs?
Yes.
Yep.
Are you able to write original music with ease, like not having writer's block or anything like that? You guys seem to jive and you're all on the same page. What are some of the topics you write about?
So Alex comes up with the main ideas and stuff like that.
I come up with the topics and I just come up with all, you know, the whole idea of what the song's going to be about. Basically, we'll write something instrumentally, we'll kind of like discuss what the song makes us think about,
and or Johnny and Aaron
being famous. Is that something you having a great time so far?
Absolutely,
yeah, it's a good time.
Yeah,
good time.
I'm glad I came across you guys on Facebook. In this day and age, I kind of just look around. I don't advertise for the show, but I came across your band, and I only reach out to certain people that I think are going to be good for the show. And you guys certainly fit that Bill, where you, I'm like, thank I know you, these man. Guys are going to come in. You guys really seemed enthusiastic.
Yeah, we were really excited.
How could you want to take over the world and bypass making a guest appearance on the Dave Scott Radio Show? I just don't see that happening.
Yeah, exactly.
All right, so this is a good career move.
This is a great milestone, a great notch on the belt.
I'm going to call you a younger guy.
Fair enough.
What is your opinion on Facebook?
Younger guy works, too.
I am starting to get the opinion through certain news articles that I read that some of the younger generation is starting to view Facebook as kind of like an old person's thing. Is there a different outlet that you use that is more socially acceptable to the younger crowd? There a new social media outlet?
Yeah, we're on Instagram.
Instagram.
But actually, Facebook has our most likes and follows and stuff. So, I mean, you know, if it's an old people thing, then
the old people really like us.
Yeah, I was gonna then I'm really old, too.
You guys, seriously. We have multiple outlets. We got, like, Twitter, Instagram, and all that stuff. So we keep up with everybody on every platform.
Well, you got the nursing home platform to fall back on if things don't work out.
Granny is because shattering in her dentures right now.
The older people are enjoying you, right? That's where you get the most likes. Where are some of the places that you've played?
Bungalow in Manchester is like our big training ground. One of our first shows there, actually, our CD release, I said this to somebody, I don't remember who it was, but when we played, I literally felt like John Lennon because there was a whole bunch of girls in the front and they were screaming louder than we were playing.
Well, we actually mentioned that he actually looks a little bit like John Lennon, right?
Yeah,
it seems like you have some new songs in the works that you haven't released yet.
Yeah.
All the time.
Yeah, we're constantly
writing. When can your fans anticipate another release from you guys?
We actually just got full funding for it. We finally got all the money together.
The Bandcamp thing, or not the Bandcamp, but the GoFundMe?
No,
like we got funding from some very generous outside sources. This was nothing to do with our parents or anything. These are
people that really believe
in what we're doing. Yes. Oh,
Your parents encourage you.
Very supportive. Yes.
Okay, do you like the Beatles, which is surprising to me, given your age. What are your favorite? What are some of your favorite Beatles songs?
Come together.
And what inspires you about a band that is so before your generation, such as the Beatles?
What makes
them stick with the young generation of you guys of today?
They're very outside of the box.
Yeah. Outside of the box.
So pretty much, they did things that no one ever heard of at the time. They were just breaking boundaries left and right.
One of the really cool things about them was when they started, they did like stuff that was strictly for like radio pop stuff, and then they did the weird stuff, which like is mind-boggling because that would be like Katy Perry doing like all this pop stuff, and then out of nowhere she does a metal band.
Your name is It's Been Real. Let's talk about the name. It's Been Real. How did you come up with that name?
It took forever for us to come up with a good
name. It almost is a perfect name because what it does, it's something that you would pretty much say to anybody at the end of any given night. Hey, It's Been Real.
And that's how we
people think about when they think about your band, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
Would you think of expanding to a 4-piece or 5-piece at some point in time?
We are actually looking for someone to do turntables and keyboards. Yeah, like Incubus and Deftones and stuff like that to give it more of like a modern edge. Yeah, stuff like that. While we were recording our EP, we recorded 9 songs originally, which hardcore fans know that we only have 6 on there. And what happened was the label that we're on advised us to do 6. So we left the other 3 off. But there's also a little secret, interlude type of thing where we're just making weird noises.
That was going to happen before the last song, which was a secret song, but it never happened.
Yeah.
So nothing was ever a secret.
Maybe the next one.
Oh, he's good. He's good.
So there was all this ridiculous stuff in that little interlude, like Steve making dolphin noises.
No, I wasn't making the dolphin noises.
Okay.
I was making the gargling sounds over his dolphin noises.
Can you show us some of those gargling sounds?
wait.
Hey guys, this almost sounds like the Abbey Road recordings.
Well, I already got the John Lennon look in here, so I mean, there we go. There's those disgusting gargling noises.
Plug your ears. There's more coming.
I can't believe Dave let us take over this radio station. This is a privilege.
He left us.
And we're gonna milk it.
It's about keeping the crowd motivated when you're playing shows.
Oh, right? Yeah. It's more about the show than what you're right, actually
playing.
When
you're doing that, they must really be in tune with you guys.
We actually have a song that we'll probably play later called Lollygag, and people will come up on the stage, and they'll steal the mic from us, and they'll be screaming it, and it's the most beautiful thing ever.
It's really awesome experience.
Yeah, it's so cool.
We are here for the duration of the night, I believe. We're having such a good time with these guys. You have some social media pages. Just remind the listening audience one more time where they can find your information.
We got Facebook, Twitter, Instagram.
Your Bandcamp.
Bandcamp.
iTunes.
SoundCloud.
Now, are there
Spotify.
More, there are more songs.
To a show.
Are there more songs on your Bandcamp page than are on the CD?
Actually, no. It's the same amount. But if you go on SoundCloud, I uploaded all the songs except for one. There's one song that has never seen the light of day.
Right. I'm pretty sure I know what song that is.
Yeah, it's Care, actually.
Oh,
Care.
Really?
Yeah, we have this demo song that we called Taco Tits because we were bored. And yeah, I know it's kind of offensive, but yeah. We were bored and we're young and dumb.
It was easy to remember.
Yeah, very easy to remember.
What do we call this riff? I don't know.
We just lost our PG rating here on the show.
There was this guy that hit us up and he wanted us to do like a pay-to-play type of thing. So it's like sell X amount of tickets. And
Those are tough.
We don't like to do that just because it feels really like forced. Like everyone that goes, like, oh, you have to go.
Well, if
like,
you don't get rid of the tickets, essentially you're paying to play.
Yeah, which just feels kind of like
you're working your ass off to pay.
Yeah, and then you don't even get any of the money after. So it's like you're doing all this work to play.
And you owe money. You owe money.
And then it's not even guaranteed if the other people do it too. You know, someone else could like join the gig and then not bring anybody and just pay out of their pocket. So then like you could be playing for your own people, pretty much.
Or if nobody shows up.
Yeah, that too. Then you're just totally screwed.
Yeah. Okay. This is the first. This has got to be a unique performance. If you guys ever end up on MTV Unplugged, I'm going to say, I had the guys first right here on the Dave Scott Show.
All the rights are reserved here.
Yeah, the Dave Scott Show. 50-50 rights between all of us, right?
Exactly.
So this is great. I'm having a great time with you guys here tonight. The band, It's Been Real, performing here on the Dave Scott Show. They are from the New Hampshire area. You can catch them playing live. They are from the Manchester area. Hit them up on their Facebook page, on their social media pages.
Facebook.
Twitter.
Instagram.
Actually, this was really cool. I Googled ourselves recently because I have a huge ego. And I just did it. And we actually showed up on Google as the only band, as It's Been Real.
Really?
Yeah, we showed up like right there, top result.
And I would trademark that real
made
quick.
Made me so happy. We are registered as like a business or something like that.
You make a lot of friends being in a band, right?
Yeah,
like the fan mail, how do you deal with fan mail? Like, you can't respond to everything, right?
I mean, well, we haven't had, like, fan mail, per se, but we've had, like, some obsessives out there. I won't name names, because we do love them, but there are some who take it, like, really, really seriously.
Right.
And it's kind of cool, because it's like, you know, we take this really seriously. To see that passion in the crowd is amazing. But sometimes
when you could make the connection with somebody,
it's priceless.
Really, it's almost better than getting paid.
People
will come up to us and they'll just be like, "I really, really enjoyed your music."
I'd rather have a fan than $100.
It's not an easy life. You're traveling around. You mentioned playing Connecticut, some other places where you're traveling close to 100 miles for a gig sometimes. What's that like?
It's awesome, actually.
Just
it's a lot of fun.
Stop at McDonald's every 30 miles.
Yeah, Wendy's. Wendy's. Shout out to Wendy's.
Yeah.
Wendy's.
Baconator Days.
Do you have management? Somebody guiding you guys, pointing you in the right direction?
We have a little bit. I do most of the behind the scenes, but I get help from, there's this guy named Tom who's actually here in Concord, and he's like,
he's like
the secret fourth member.
Okay.
This dude has been working. Like, he saw us, and he was so motivated, inspired by us, that he's been behind us since then.
Yeah, you need somebody working behind the scenes for you. You have T-shirts with a cool logo, right?
Yeah, definitely.
It's like a robot.
Yeah, that was created by a friend of Johnny's, actually.
That was my ex-girlfriend. We have the robot. We've got a Life is Good knockoff with a panda head, and then we've got some plain It's Been Real shirts with just the logo on it.
Okay, nice.
The panda ones have been going like crazy, so gotta act fast and get in on that.
Are you guys going to remain active playing shows all summer long?
Yes.
We're going
to be... Yeah.
So you'll be adding dates.
We'll be doing a quick break in there to record our new EP, and then after that...
And then...
Just going all...
Okay, yeah. So you are going to release...
It's
going to
be a great...
Yeah. Yeah, tour. I forgot about that. We were going to try to do a tour for the summer. Yeah.
Oh, tour.
Okay. Yeah, we did a tour last summer that was amazing, so we want to do that again.
So you...
Shout out to those guys, because... That was an amazing time.
Yeah, seriously. Shout out to 5x2 Records, Pillbook, Company One,
Robert McCarthy,
Beneath the Running Board, and Matt Arano, that legendary, awesome
shout
dude.
Out to Circus Trees.
Circus Trees.
You guys shout out to NH Booking.
NH Booking.
Richie Downs.
Richie Downs.
Releasing another CD,
hopefully,
in the upcoming year.
Is that in the works?
Hopefully in the next few months.
Yes. Okay, great.
Yeah, like, 2 months tops, we should be done with the new material that we're doing, and then hopefully demoing it for the new EP.
Right. Is the new CD going to be a full length?
It is not. It's going to be another EP.
All right. I noticed you've got 6 songs on the CD here.
Yeah.
From an Artificial View.
That I have. And what's the name of this title of this?
The Sky from an Artificial View.
Okay, great. I will definitely be checking this out. I'll be giving it some airtime as well in the upcoming weeks here on the Dave Scott Show.
Thank you, Dave.
Thank you.
All right. One more time, hey, can we get a round of applause for these guys?
Round of applause for Dave.
Yeah, here on Dave Scott.
Beautiful human.
How many original songs do you have in the works, aside from the 6 that you have on the CD?
Well, we just finished a new one, and now we have 2 that are about to be worked on.
Pending.
3.
Three.
And we have 3 pending, and then there's like 6 others that are just in this void of songs that we never use or play.
Where do you practice out of? Do you have a jam room?
Yeah. Yeah, it used to be his house, and now we moved it to mine.
We were at my house for about a year.
Okay.
A little over a year.
What I was getting at is, where are you going to be recording the new CD? You going to a professional studio?
There have been a few studios that I've been eyeballing that I kind of like. We went to Laurel Wood Studio.
Okay. Tell us about that studio. What was your experience like?
It was a lot of fun. It was one guy. He engineered it, produced it. Yeah, Nick DiTuccio. Able to kind of like insert himself into the process of it without him being like, oh, like I'm a fourth member, like I did this on the record, but like he at the same time like kind of helped out a little bit. It's a little bit of a surprise.
Okay,
but
different instruments.
Not different instruments. We're gonna have some singers come in and we're gonna have them do a part.
Good.
Yeah, and then a saxophonist. I had an idea for saxophone.
Okay,
little part.
I do want to thank you guys for coming on the show. Keep in touch. I'd like to have you guys back on at some point in time. Keep me updated on what's going on with your CD. We'll do it again sometime. How's